happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to another video. Today, we are back on MAFM V2 here in FS13. So as you saw in Tuesday's video, we got the mowing finished over there. So we're going to hook up the 6640 here to the rake, and we're gonna go ahead and go do some raking some raking over there. So I was kind of hoping to do some of this in Tuesday's video, but it took way longer to mow all that than I thought it was going to. So instead, that's what we're doing in this episode. Okay. So I gotta remember. So it's Z and N. And then X and M. And of course, having this on a front loader tractor is not going to be that great. Okay, so let's see just how fast we can drive. Evidently, I can't adjust these. Ah, it's plus and minus in this tractor. Okay. So we can go 17. So yeah, we'll start some baling and just kind of see how many bales we make. I'm hoping that, like, I can get the 70 bales off this field and then still have, like, a lot of hay left. So that way we can get some silage made too, or some haylage. And then if not, I still have, as you saw, the 1370 is still hooked up to the mower. So if it takes all of this field to make those 70 bales, then we'll just kind of sit and cut a whole bunch of ditches. You know, we can cut these ditches all the way around. We can cut the waterways. You know, the spaces in between some fields. You know, there's all kinds of areas that we can go mow. So we'll go ahead and do that then. Okay, so let's get this guy unfolded. Okay, so now I need to remember, I need to figure out here. Okay, so extend that. That extended, yeah. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and extend this arm as well. Get as wide of a reach as is possible. Cool. So now, let's see. Alright, so now I think we're good to go. I haven't used this rake here in 13 in ages. Yep, we're good to go. Whoa, except we gotta go way slower than that. Huh, this rake sucks. What are the other options? Yeah, this rake is horrible. Quite skippy. Come on. Load. 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 There we go. Wind recorders. That's way too small. That's way too dang big. Okay, I guess we'll just go with this guy. So we will sell that one. Buy that one. And I will be back in just a moment. Okay, and we're back. So I got the duals off the 10 and got it hooked up to the crone here. So we're gonna go ahead and use the 10 here to do some raking. And yeah, this crone squadro is one of my favorite rakes here in 13. My other favorite's got to be the Tanuti Millennium, the V-Rake. That one I also really, really enjoy. Actually, that's one thing that I really want to convert to 15, or, you know, redo and convert. But obviously you have to work at that one. I don't think there's been any V-Rakes for 15. Not as far as I know, anyways. I suppose there could be, and I just don't know, but... and nobody's converted that one over or anything. So it's definitely something that is missing from 15. I mean, it was possible here in 13. It's definitely possible there in 15 as well. That's something I'd like to do one day, but and I think that's even like the same brand as the one that we have at our farm. I'm pretty sure that's the brand on it. It may not be the same model, but it's the same brand, and it's a V-Rake, so down for the turn here. Not even gonna have to come back here with the rake, because this is gonna be set up for a windrow here already. So that's nice. I know whenever I've baled this field, I remember always getting like a whole bunch of bales off of it, so I'm hoping that happens here so that way we can make our 70 bales pretty quick and then use the rest of this for haylage, so that way we can ferment that into the bunk, you know, throw that in the bunkers, ferment it, and get some silage out of that. So, 'cause that would definitely be a big help. To get lots of bales pretty fast, that way our 70 bales will fly by, and then we'll hopefully get a lot of haylage, that way we won't have to do any mowing for a while, I hope. We won't have a whole lot of cows. I think only like 100 is maybe all I'll be able to buy or something like that. Maybe a little less, like 75 or something. But we won't buy any until we've got, you know, all the silage and everything ready for it. Otherwise, then they're just kind of sitting there and they're not being very productive. be better to be ready for them. You know, even like as much as having the mixer wagon ready to go already or something, you know. So yeah, I'm actually recording this on Sunday. I'm getting a bunch of videos cranked out so that way I don't have to do a whole lot of recording throughout the week. I'm actually back to studying again. I am currently studying for my ACT test, which I have to take on February 11th. So my days have been study that for a while and then do whatever video stuff and then go out and shovel, because there seems to be no end to the shoveling. In a way, I kind of almost want to sell the 1370 and the 6640 and just buy another 1086 and then a 986 with a loader, or just a 986 with loader or something like that. Just because these tractors I really like. I mean, I'm not a huge fan of red, but these are definitely a favorite. These things are awesome. And then we can stop right there. Get turned around. I have a feeling I wouldn't make that turn, so, or if I did, it'd probably be all messy. Yeah, so far I've got Monday's video recorded, Tuesday's video recorded, and now I'm working here on Saturday. So then after this, I'm planning to kind of keep an eye out on the Cowboys and Packers game. I'm a Cowboys fan and a Packers fan, so this game is, it's one of those hard games where it's like, you know. Normally I'd say I really don't care who wins, but right now I'm kind of hoping the Cowboys win, because then they'd be heading to the playoffs and hopefully having a chance at going to the Super Bowl. I'm pretty sure this is the farthest they've made it in forever, really, you know, so long. And so that'd be pretty cool to see. They have a pretty good team this year, now that they got rid of Romo, and have put Prescott in, have him running quarterback position, and he's done pretty dang good so far. And I probably should have waited to rake that till after. Actually, I know what I'll do. I'll just come back and rake a third section right here. That is what I'll do. That's what I'll do. Okay, so I'm just gonna set up a GPS line here. make it so we got some that way we got some nice straight windrows, and hopefully can maintain the two row passes, I'll say, I guess. I don't know. But yeah, so then after this video, I'll go and get the Thursday modding video recorded. And then I have to see whether I'm doing my summer car or not. Because still, as of now, Monday's video hasn't gone up saying, you know, with the, you know, want summer car or no. That's today's video for me. So the Sunday video, if... if you haven't seen that, I was talking about some updates that were coming in the future, and then also seeing whether you wanted my summer car in replace of American Truck Sim or in addition to. So you know, by now that's already been decided, I'm sure. So. But, or by the time you're watching this video, I guess I should say. But for me, I still have like an hour and a half until the video goes up talking about that. So, I have to wait until, probably until like Tuesday I'll wait or something like that. Wait to figure that out. Whoa, almost hit that there. Almost hit the fence. So yeah, I finally have finished up my dual lift DC6050 cone bottom trailer, as you have seen in Thursday's video. If you haven't checked that video out, be sure to go check that out. Did work on that on Thursday. I already know, as of now, that's what I have planned for Thursday moddings, or for the Thursday modding of this week, since I have finished that. So, at the moment, I don't know what I did in that video, obviously, since I haven't gotten to that. But I just know that that's what that video was of. So... yes, we're rolling along here with this raking. That's nice. So we'll do that kind of little strip there when we go to leave. I'm not sure if all this will be done on camera. It should, because we still got 11 minutes. So we're only 20 minutes in. And a lot of the time was spent. Yeah, we should be done, because this is going pretty fast. So then on Tuesday we'll be finishing up, or we'll be bailing, I mean, not finishing anything, not starting anything, bailing. That's what we'll be doing then. So we'll see how many bales we can pull off of this field. Hopefully a lot. Otherwise we'll be doing a lot more mowing. And if I end up doing more mowing, I'm using a different tractor, because the 1370 is a little slow for driving down the road, and it just takes forever to get anywhere. I'd probably use this tractor on it. It's probably a little more power than I need, but it definitely would be nice to have. It's funny how like only every other windrow appears when I zoom way out. No animated PTO on this guy. I noticed as I was doing the time-lapse video, I noticed that the mower has an animated PTO, except for whatever reason, nothing is aligned on that mower to the 1370. Like the three-point pins are like above and in front of the mower, of the slots on the mower for them. And then the PTO is like down, like down underneath of the tractor. It's really strange. Evidently that mower's indexes are way off or something weird, I don't know. Or it just doesn't like that tractor. Hard to say. Oh, I dropped that way too soon. Whatever. I didn't pick up the other windrow, so that's good, I guess. Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna stop this timer and we'll just mow or record till we're done raking and get back to the farm, and then we'll be set. There really isn't all that much left. I mean, it's kind of going by. Ah! I hate that when it doesn't lift. Like, this thing, it does not lift or lower very fast. Guess I'll just have to convert to stopping. So we've got, I'm gonna guess, 5, maybe 6 more passes or something like that. That's just a guess, of course. I'm not even sure how much is left to rake here. She's blowing a little bit of smoke here going up the hill. I think it was, even, you know, all the time. It's in that little snippet there that can just stay there whenever we turn with either the baler or the rake or the wagon. Whichever, pick it up. These windrows are not even aligned anyways. They should be like right in the, on the sides of that little flap there. I'm guessing, I'm pretty sure that's how this rake would work in real life. There aren't rakes like this around here, that's for sure. It's all wheel rakes. None of these fancy PTO ones like you see in like the UK and overseas and whatever. Maybe somebody has brought one over from you know, like a foreign place, had one shipped or something. See, like, now this is pretty accurate, I would assume. I'm assuming that, you know, when these spin, it hits over there and then just drops, and then that's your windrow. I'm assuming that's how it works, but like I said, I have no idea. Yeah, we're we're almost done. Sweet. So I want to see here, does this... Oh, sweet. This is going to line up pretty dang well. Awesome. That worked out pretty nicely. Cool beans. So we got, what was it, 3-4 passes left, I think. So we're pretty close to done. Huh. One, two, yep, so now we're down to two more. So we're almost done. So this should not take long at all to finish up. The farm is slowly disappearing. I almost did not catch that. Had this thing taken like 5 seconds more to lift, I'd have picked up that other windmill. So this tractor's pretty much main workhorse on the farm, actually. We got this for running the drill. This will run the fertilizer spreader, probably. This runs the rake. This will run the baler. This will have to run, well, maybe the, yeah, well, this will run the load, the forage wagon. Not sure. I'll probably, the 1370 will probably run the mixer. That'll probably be fine since that won't have far to go and doesn't require much. But this thing does most jobs. Turn it like that. Actually, I need this back for just a sec. Turn off the lines for the screenshot. And of course, we have the grass. Dang it! Darn grass is photobombing me. There we go. Our lines brought back up. So then we can actually use this. Well, no, we really can't because a lot of these windrows are offset. I was gonna say we could use it for rake or baling and picking up, but really can't because that won't work that well. Won't work as well as I thought it was going to. Come on, tractor, get going. I think actually what I'm going to do here, we're going to kick these windrows back just a little bit. We're going to do that by picking up a little more here. Back up, back up, back up. There we go. So let's kind of get these windrows set back a little bit here. Just like that, and then we'll get over here, drop this down, go like this to pick up these sections, and we'll just kind of combine this into there, Perfect. Oh, I gotta lift it first. Alright, guys, and that is it. So, yeah, the next video we'll be working on some baling. So, yeah, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links for my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are definitely worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.